Kinematics. Kinematics first thing is rest and motion. What is rest? Right now you are sitting at home and watching the online class. Your parents or your siblings can say that you are at rest. Yeah? But you know, Earth revolves around the sun and it takes 365 days to complete one revolution. So if a person is standing on some other satellites or planets, what he'll observe? He'll observe that you are moving, you are not at rest. Yeah? But why your parents or your brother, sister are saying you are at rest? Because you are not changing your position with respect to them. Them means that is the surrounding. Anything nearby you, it's called you, your surrounding. So if a body does not change its position with respect to surrounding with time, then body is said to be at rest. Clear? A simple example is if you are moving in a train and train is fully covered. The windows are covered with curtains. And you and your colleague are sitting opposite to each other. Face to face, what you will observe? You will observe that you are at rest. But a person which is standing or platform or outside the train, what the person will observe? The person will observe that you are moving, right? Because the train is changing its position with respect to that person or surrounding with time. So the person is will say the train as well as the passengers who are sitting inside the train are in motion. So rest and motion are related things. Clear? So the definition of rest, we can say if a body does not change its position with respect to surrounding with time, then body is said to be at rest. Whereas if a body changes its position with respect to surrounding with time, then body is said to be in motion. Clear? Okay. Second thing is uniform and non-uniform motion. Right? Uniform motion means suppose your body is moving. In 1 second it covers 5 meters, the other second, other next 1 second again covers 5 meters, and next second again covers 5 meters. Means in every second the distance covered by the body is equal. Then body is said to be in uniform motion. Uniform motion means if a body covers equal distances, equal intervals of time, then body is said to be in uniform motion. And if like sometimes riding on scooty or two wheelers in the market, what happens? Sometimes you find road is clear, your scooty is faster, but if there's traffic or people are crossing the road, then speed becomes less. So it means in that motion, your two wheeler or you are not covering equal distance and equal interval of time. Sometimes you are covering more distance at the same time, and sometimes you are covering less distance at the same time. So it means you are not covering equal distance in equal intervals of time. So if a body is not covering equal distance in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be in non-uniform. Clear? Uniform motion means the body will cover equal distance in equal intervals of time, whereas in non-uniform motion, the body will cover unequal distance in equal intervals of time. So definitions are simple. If a body covers equal distance in equal intervals of time, then body is said to be in uniform motion. Whereas if a body covers unequal distance in equal intervals of time or equal distance in unequal intervals of time, then body is said to be non-uniform. Clear? Next thing comes now, distance and displacement. Clear? So suppose we are having two points A and B, and say the distance between these two points is 2 km. A person is suppose moving like this. First, he goes to A to C, then to B, and then to say B, and finally to B. So it is 1 km. This is also 1 km. So it is 2 km. This is say 2 km, and this is again 2 km. And another person is moving directly from A to B. Here, both the persons are reaching at B, starting from A. So what will happen? This person has to travel a path of 1 + 1, 2 and 3, 4 and 3, 6 km. That is S1. Whereas second person is traveling simply 2 km. Here, distance means the person. This person has covered a distance of 6 km, whereas second person has covered a distance of 2 km. Though their initial and final positions are same. Okay. So distance means total path covered. Length of total path covered. This is called distance. Displacement means the shortest distance between initial and final positions.
आप कंटिन्यू करो.
So distance depends on the path. Like the rest, person first goes to C, then D, then E, and then B. Whereas displacement is the shortest distance. And always remember, the shortest distance between two points will always be a straight line. Clear? And the difference between distance and displacement. First is, distance is the length of actual path covered. Whereas displacement is the shortest distance between initial and final position. Second, distance is scalar quantity. Killer quantity means the physical quantity which needs magnitude and unit to describe it. Clear? Whereas displacement is a vector quantity. Vector quantity are those quantities which needs magnitude, unit, as well as direction. Right? It depends on direction also. First thing, distance will always be positive. Distance will never be negative. Clear? Whereas displacement may be zero, may be negative, may be positive. Clear? Other thing, the distance will never be less than displacement. Distance will either be equal to displacement or greater than displacement. It will never be less than displacement. Whereas displacement will never be greater than distance. Either it will be equal to distance or it will be less than the distance. Right? Okay? And the distance between two points may have many values because it depends on path. Through which path the person is traveling. So distance may have many values between two points, whereas displacement will have only one value. It is the shortest distance between initial and final position. Clear? Right? Next is the speed and velocity. Okay? Speed is defined as it is distance covered per unit time. Distance over time. Clear? And as far as unit of speed is concerned, unit will be in SI system. The unit of distance is meter and that of time is second. So unit will be meter per second. And dimensions V equals S over T. So dimension of V, we have already used many times in dimension analysis, that is LT minus 1. Whereas velocity equals displacement over time. Right? Displacement is a vector quantity, so velocity will also be a vector quantity. Right? And unit will be same as that of speed. And dimension are also same. That is LT minus 1. Other thing comes, that is called the average speed. Average speed equals total distance over total time. And average velocity equals total displacement upon total time. Clear? Right? So now I'm having some problems. Here is the first problem. A man walks for 1 minute. At a speed of 1 meter per second. and then run. For 1 minute at a speed of 3 meters per second. Along a straight track. What is the average speed of the man? Right? In this problem, a man walks for 1 minute. So say this T1. T1 is even 1 minute. 1 minute means 60 seconds. At a speed of 1 meter per second. So V1 equal to 1 meter per second. And then runs for 1 minute. T2 is also 1 minute. 1 minute also means 60 seconds. At a speed of 3 meter per second. So V2 is given 3 meter per second. We have to find out average speed. Right? Average speed, you know, V average equals total distance over total time. Right? So as we know, speed equals distance over time. So it will give us distance equals speed into time. Right? So suppose distance traveled in first minute is S1. S1 must be equal to V1 into T1. V1 is given 1 meter per second and T1 is 60 seconds. So it will be 60 meters. And say S2 is the distance traveled in next 1 meter. So it must be equal to V2 into T2. V2 is given 3 meter per second and T2 is 60 seconds. It equals 180 meter. So total distance means S. S must be equal to S1 plus S2. So it means this 60 plus 180 means 240 meter. And total time T equals T1 plus T2. T1 is 60 and T2 is also 60. So it is 120. Seconds. So now average speed, V average equals S over T equals S1 plus S2 upon T1 plus T2. S1 plus S2 we have calculated 240 and T1 plus T2 is 120. So this will be 2 meter per second. Clear? Next is a cyclist moving on a circular track of radius 200 meter completes one revolution in 5 minutes. What is his average speed? And second, one evolution, right? So here it is given that a track is circular, right? And its radius is given 200 meter. So a cyclist is at start at E. Then it moving like this and finally reaching here, right? So here R is given 200 meter and time is given 5 minutes. 5 minutes means 5 into 60, 300 seconds. So for first part, average speed. Again, average speed equals total distance covered upon total time taken. Right? So here, what is the total distance? Total distance is S. S must be equal to, in one revolution, it must be equal to circumference of track, means 2 pi r, S equal to 2 pi r, average speed. Equals total distance covered is 2 pi r and total time taken is t. We remember that. So it is 2 into 3.14 into 200 divided by 300. Right? So this cancels this and this cancels this. So it equals 4 into 3.14. Upon 3, right? So 3 1 3, then 0 3 4 12, then 1. So it will become nearly 1.043 and multiplied by 4. So 2 4 4 16 1 17 1 12. So it will be nearly 4. So it is nearly 4.172 meter per second. Now second part, average velocity. So for that, total displacement so initially cyclist was at A and finally again at A. Sorry. Initially cyclist was at P and finally again he is at P. What is displacement? Displacement is the shortest distance between initial and final position. And here initial and final position is same. So it means displacement is zero. If displacement is zero, it means average velocity will also be zero. Clear? Right? So now next, A body travels from A to B. At 40 meter per second, and from B to A at 60 meter per second. Calculate the average speed and velocity. Okay. So here we are having two points A and B. So body is moving from A to B, and it is V1 with 40 meter per second, and coming back with V2 is suppose 60 meter per second. So suppose the distance between A and B is suppose x. Let the distance between A and B is x. So body is moving from A to B and then coming back from B to A. So total distance will be how much? It will be AB plus BA. AB is x and BA is also x. So it's 2x. And what is total displacement? Initially body was at A and finally again body is at A. That means displacement will be zero, right? And we know speed equals distance over time. That means time equals distance over speed. So from A to B, suppose time taken is t1. So t1 must be equal to distance is x and speed is v1. V1 is 40 meter per second. So it will be x over 40. So equation number one. And from B to A, suppose it is t2. So t2 will be x over v2. X, V2 is given 60. So total time is suppose T. So T must be equal to how much? X over 40 plus X over 60. 120 is LCM. It will be 3X plus 2X. It means 5X over 120. So equation number 3. Okay. Now, average speed. Average speed equal to total distance over total time taken. Total distance was 2x and total time was taken as 5x upon 120. X and x cancels out, it will go up. So it will give you 120 into 2 upon 5. It means 240 over 5. And 240 over 5 will give you 48 meter per second. And since total displacement is 0, equal to average velocity will be how much? 0 upon time taken is 5x over 120. It will go up. 0 into 120 over 5x. what will be zero. So average speed will be 48 meter per second and average velocity will be zero. So now time is almost finished. So this is enough for today. Then we will see you tomorrow. Thank you very much.